My dear brothers and sisters, from the very beginning, all the three persons of the Holy Trinity was at work. Because in the book of Genesis, we know that the Spirit of God was hovering on the waters. However, we in the Old Testament see more the activities of God the Father. Then during the public ministry of Jesus, the activities of the second person, Jesus Christ. And then he told the disciples, as we read in today's gospel, that it is good that he would go, because he will send his spirit upon the disciples. And keeping up his promise, he sent the Holy Spirit upon the apostles on the 50th day after his resurrection. So Pentecost means 50th. So on the 50th day, the Holy Spirit came upon them. And Pentecost has an Old Testament background, because it is an Old Testament celebration of the Israelites. And it was originally a harvest feast, because they were thanking God for all the good harvest, especially wheat harvest that they received. And it was also a remembrance of the covenant that God made with Israel on Mount Sinai through Moses. And that happened on the 50th day after the original Passover. That means after they left the Egypt, they traveled 40 days and then they arrived at Mount Sinai. On the 50th day, the God gave the 10 commandments inscribed on stone. But on the commemoration of that same feast, the Holy Spirit came upon the apostles, and the commandment of love was inscribed on the hearts of the people. So the flame came on each individual apostle. So they began to speak in different languages, because they began to speak in their own language, but all people gathered there from different parts of the world began to understand in their own languages. And that was a miracle that happened. So people were so much taken up by that kind of an experience, because these disciples were Galileans. So they speak Aramaic or Hebrew, so Aramaic or Greek. And still the people came from all over the three continents could understand the languages that they preached. And at that time, 3,000 people were converted at the preaching of St. Peter. And that was a remembrance of what happened in the Tower of Babel. That story we know, that people were competing with God. After the deluge, the great flood, they wanted to build a big tower so that if God punishes humanity with another flood, they could escape themselves from by climbing the top of that tower. But God destroyed that, maybe through an earthquake, and dispersed them to 70 nations with the different languages so that they could not understand one another. And now, in this great feast of Pentecost, people from all nations are able to understand the language of the apostles. And the apostles went to all the nations and preached the gospel. And so also in the Mount Sinai, 3,000 people were killed, because when Moses was on the top of Mount Sinai for 40 days and nights, people were saying that Moses might have died, because there is nothing on the top of the mountain, there are only stones. So how could he survive? So thinking that, they thought the God had abandoned them, Moses is gone, their leader. So they asked Aaron, his brother, to help them to give them a god, the god of Egypt. And Aaron asked them to bring all the gold they have. They brought gold from Egypt, borrowing from the Egyptians. And so he melted the gold ornaments and made this golden calf, and people began to worship the golden calf that they had already left in Egypt, instead of worshipping God. And so God punished them. So Moses asked them, now those who are willing to keep the covenant of God and keep the only one and true God, you come to this side. So he put a line. And only the Levites, the same tribe of Moses and Aaron, came to that side. All the others, they abandoned the true worship of God. And so the Levites were asked to kill the leaders of all the other tribes, and the priesthood was taken from them. Until that time, the head of the families were the priests. And now only Levites were selected to be the priests. And so 3,000 people were killed by the Levites according to the commandment of Moses. And now in this experience of the new Pentecost, 3,000 people were converted. So there is some kind of parallelism between the Pentecost of the Old Testament and the Pentecost of the New Testament. So in the New Testament, on the day of Pentecost, the Holy Spirit came upon the apostles, just like God came in the form of fire and smoke on the Mount Sinai, here on Mount Zion or Mount Jerusalem. The Holy Spirit came upon the apostles and they were transformed. And with that transformation, the apostles were courageous enough to preach the gospel. They began to understand all the teachings of Jesus Christ, and they began to realize the fulfillment of the Holy Scripture in Jesus Christ. So also we also received the same Holy Spirit at the time of baptism. And we know that the baptism of John was with water, whereas the baptism of Jesus was with the Holy Spirit. And thus we all received the baptism of Jesus Christ, and at the time of baptism we received the Holy Spirit, and then at the time of confirmation, and now it is done all together. The addition of the Holy Spirit was more prominent in our lives. So we have to realize that the Spirit of God is at work with us. And that is the difference between a Christian and a non-Christian. And also we are nourished with the body and blood of Jesus Christ and the Word of God at the time of the Holy Mass. So we hear about seven gifts of the Holy Spirit, and they are wisdom, understanding, knowledge, counsel, fortitude, piety, and fear of God. And so wisdom means the wisdom to distinguish between right and wrong. So when King Solomon, the son of King David, was enthroned, he went to worship God on a mountain, and he offered 1,000 offerings and prayed to God. And then God was pleased, and God asked him, what kind of favor you want? So he could ask like a long life, defeat the enemies, broadening his kingdom, a more plenty of wealth, but he did not ask any of those kind of things. Those are all material things. Instead, he asked God for wisdom, so that he said, I'm young and there are a lot of people who belong to you. Now I'm going to govern these people on behalf of you. And so give me the wisdom to understand difference between right and wrong. And we know that after Jesus, Solomon was the most wise person ever born in this world. His wisdom is well known. So also the Holy Spirit gives us the wisdom to distinguish between the right and wrong. Then the understanding, that is the ability to understand or comprehend the meaning of God's message. God's message should be understood through the events of this life, for example, like COVID or whatever good things or bad things happen in our lives, and also from the scripture. And then the knowledge. Knowledge is the ability to experience God's revelation, explore the Lord's revelation. So when we read the Bible, we comprehend or we understand the scripture in different ways. And also the counsel. Counsel is the ability to give advice or guide others in the proper way. So guiding the children, guiding the friends, guiding people who are non-believers or people who are in trouble. And then the fortitude is the courage to give witness to the Lord even in the midst of sufferings or persecution. We know that in the early church there were so many persecutions, and even in our own lives we will face different kind of challenges. Our material prosperity, or our health issues, or our job issues, or educational issues. Regardless of any of these adverse or good situations, we should have the courage. And that is what the apostles received, so that Stephen was bold enough to preach the gospel even to the Sanhedrin. So also Peter and Saul, they all faced all kinds of challenges. Then the piety is that helps us to pray God with a true devotion. And then the fear of Lord, according to the Bible, fear of Lord is not just a fear, it is a reverence to God, a respect towards God. And thus, we are blessed with these seven gifts, but we also have to realize that they are in work in us. And then we hear about the 12 fruits of the from the descent of the Holy Spirit upon us. They are charity, the willingness to help others, the joy, even in the midst of sufferings or persecution. We should enjoy the life, the joy that we have in this world and the joy to come. And then the peace, the patience, the kindness, the goodness, the forbearance, the mildness or gentleness, faith, modesty, and self-control and chastity. So let us try to realize the presence of God within us, especially the Holy Spirit that is guiding the church in the modern, in this present age and in our own lives, and also the nourishment that Jesus gives through his body and blood and through the word of God, and try to give witness to the Lord according to the gifts that we have received through the coming of the Holy Spirit.